Hello friends, welcome back. This is your host Khushbu Rolly on Desi Plaza TV. We are talking to Sai Sharan Senpon, our teenage star, karate star from our Irving, Texas area. So Sai Sharan, you shared so much information. We know you want to be world number one champ in karate. Besides that, is there anything else that you would want to pursue in, let's say, in your future or in your life?
So for the first time in history, karate is being included in the Olympic Games at the Junior Olympics in Buenos Aires, Argentina. So by winning the Pan American Championship in 2017, I have qualified to compete. But unfortunately, I've heard that the U.S. Olympic Committee will not take a karate team to the Junior Olympics. So,
so that's one thing we need to... kind of something that needs to be worked upon by the, it seems, government, because Olympics is something which is governed by the government and rests where the private competitions. So only if this rule changes, maybe you can qualify. Okay, that's on your next to-do list. Mm-hmm. So hopefully you make it, hopefully something works out for you, and we would definitely wish for you. So besides that, any other tournaments in next year that you would like to participate in?
Next year is, again, the same rotation of tournaments, so U.S. Open, Nationals, again, there will be a Junior Pan American Championships, so it'll be almost more or less the same number of tournaments.
Okay, sounds good. All the best. So, anything that you, somebody who provided you special support, would you like to say anything to our viewers over here in Desi Plaza TV?
I would just ask for some more recognition for the sport of karate, because compared to like basketball or football, there's not really much support that we get from the government or even private sponsors. So every international trip is really expensive, so it's all coming out of our own pocket. And the USA Karate Federation doesn't really support the junior athletes in trips for even representing the United States. So it gets really expensive sometimes. But the Texas Karate Federation has given a good amount of money to these trips, so I'd like to say thanks to them.
That's cool. That's awesome by Texas Karate Federation. But yeah, as we all know, these things are expensive. Of course, travel is expensive and all. So working towards it, taking those classes, and on the top of it, you have to manage it all on your own. It piles up. And and sport is sometimes connected to business in such a way that, you know, you get the funding and all that. Mm-hmm. And I hope it works out. So friends, we need to support this sport more, it seems, over here in USA, so that our players can get more support morally and financially. Let's hope for the best for them. And we shall also now talk to the coach, who is happens to be his father, Mr. Senthil Thiagarajan. So friends, we have amongst us now Sai Sharan Senpon's coach and father, Senthil Thiagarajan. He is actually also founder of Champions Karate Academy, which has three branches, one in Frisco, the main one is in Irving, and one in Louisville as well. Besides that, he is a president of Texas Sport Karate Federation. So thank you so much, Mr. Senthil, for giving us your time. First of all, I would like to ask you about your experience when your son won the championship and he won gold. How was the moment and all your hard work actually, you know, you saw the result in front of your eyes? How was it?
Definitely that was one of the proudest moments in our life, because both myself and my wife, Ponmala Senthil, we both was there, but not as an spectator, as an official, as a judge, as a referee for that event. Especially when he was doing his finals match, all his match, I was refereeing in the other ring. Mm-hmm. I could not watch his fight. I was like sneaking here and there whenever I get a break. But
that's tough. When
he won the finals, we were like, I cannot celebrate much because as an official, I'm inside. But it was really a proud moment. If I was not inside that on the ring as an official, both myself, my wife, we might have tears in our eyes, you know, because that was the proud moment. That was one of our dream come true, one of the first goal, because no one from, you know, including myself, my wife, we never reached that level. And he's the first Indian
child has
origin.
Your dreams to light, you know, through you, because you were there to support him all throughout. And it also says so much about your dedication towards what you do, even as a referee and everything, because you had to be composed there because you had to do what you had to do. But no wonder, we all understand your feelings. And as a father, definitely it is a most proud moment. Congratulations again for that.
Thank you.
So how is your experience training him, and where do you see him a few years from now? What are your goals for him?
Yeah, at this moment, I'd definitely like to thank my wife, because she was the first, I can say she was the first coach to my son when he started karate at three, at the age of three. She is the one who was coaching, because I was traveling. I have a traveling job, mm-hmm. so only weekends I come. I don't want to, you know, you know. I just rather want to play with him rather than teach karate. Mm-hmm. So my wife was, you know, technically his first coach. Mm-hmm. So it's a great experience, but it is also is a tough experience, because as a father son, as a coach student, I know to maintain the balance, you know, it's really, it's hard to maintain, but somehow we manage as a team.
Definitely have successfully managed.
Me, my wife and son, you know, we both manage, because that, you know, to achieve at this level, it definitely needs a dedication from all of three, you know, not only just an athlete, coach and parents. So as a coach, as a parents, mm-hmm. you know, maybe it's a little bit easy for us, because mm-hmm. we are this coach, personal coach and parents. So we understand how much dedication he needs to, you know, how much hard work he needs to put on. Apart from his dojo training, we call dojo, the karate school is dojo. Mm-hmm. He also, we make him practice at home, mm-hmm. you know, or even sometimes at the park outside. We both used to go jogging outside together. Those are the proud moments, you know.
He can't do swinging on the park.
Yeah, now no swinging.
Ever since three.
Oh yeah, I mean, definitely, you know, as a kid, he did not, I can say he did not get that, that a kid's experience, you know, mm-hmm. as playing more in the park. You know? Mm-hmm. Most of the time you practice rather than swinging, you know. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So,
That's amazing. I mean, that's the family hard work coming together, and you can definitely see the success as it is in front of all of our eyes. And as they say, mothers are often the first teachers. And if you have such an amazing, focused teacher, you know, it's a blessing and seems like a destiny. And even your life, as we all know, that you had, your father was in boxing, right?
Oh, he's a great boxer. Yeah.
You had that discipline, and your family has that. And we wish you all the best. Honestly, may all your dreams, and may all dreams of Senthil, your son, and your family, your daughter as well, may all those come true. And we wish you all the best from Desi Plaza TV and all of our viewers. Anything that you would like to say to our listeners before we sign off?
Sure. This victory, you know, is just a beginning, you know, and this is definitely a motivation for not only him and all his, you know, other young athletes. Mm-hmm. We have at our academy, we have a great competition team. We call it as mm-hmm. Team CK. A lot of junior athletes who is going to follow his you know, footsteps, and we are very, very happy that he made it, because now we have proof, you know, we have an athlete achieved in that level. So the upcoming junior athletes, they know, okay, they see he's already did it, Sai did it, why can't we also, we can also do it. So that's the positive, you know, motivation he brought, you know, Sai brought it to our academy. And not only that, we are very glad that, you know, after this win, he did not take that win to his head. It's very important.
Yes,
he came back and started training, and that's really amazing. And he's a true athlete, mm-hmm. and we are very glad that he's matured. He's going to be, you know, one of the big assets for our academy. Mm-hmm. And definitely, not only his dream, our dream and our prayers for him is to become a world champion, to be an Olympian in the future. Following him, we have other, not only him, I mean, also the other athletes, you know, not one Olympian, we will have soon more Olympians in our academy.
Absolutely. Wish you all the best for your academy, and I'm pretty sure there are a lot of teenagers and tiny future leaders and all the masters being trained over there. So wish you all the best, and definitely Sai Sharan is a level-headed kid, and he is an icon for all of us. And as you said, he's pretty focused, and he comes back and practices. So, well, all the best. What else can be done? Hard work and in the right direction, and has the passion. What else do you need? And with right kind of people around, right team, right coaches and everything. Well, we are glad to have you here, and thank you so much for giving us your time. Wish you all the best for all your dreams.
Thank you very much, Ms. Krishma, and I'd like to thank Desi Plaza TV. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
So coming back to Sai, Shin, and Senpon, thank you so much for giving us your time and actually giving your time to this sport, because that's where you have achieved your name and made all of us proud, honestly. So it's about our community, Irving, Texas, and even USA. And may universe be with you, may all the blessings with you. May Sai Baba's blessing be with you, and entire team of the Desi Plaza TV, seriously, sincerely wishes you all the best. Keep rocking, keep doing the hard work, and we wish you all the best. Thank you so much.
Thank you for this opportunity.
So thank you so much for your time. And of course, it's your hard work and it's your own effort and which has taken you so far. And but seems like you're blessed to have a family that you have, which kept you focused. And I think your journey is super awesome, because you might have met the right teammates and appropriate coaches who kept you going, and good experiences. So anything else that you would like to share the team of DC Plaza TV before you sign off from here?
First off, I would like to thank both my parents, for without them I would have not been at the stage where I am right now. For every loss, they've always been with me. For every win, they've always been with me. My sister, for not really doing anything but being there. But
that's mean. She helped you for sure.
My teammates at CKA for being there for every practice that I've needed or I've wanted. For without them, I would be punching at a target for a couple hours. And so the U.S. national team coaches for fixing any small mistakes I've made in Argentina or any trips that I've been with them. All my fans for always supporting me and cheering me on. That really keeps me going. And finally, to Andres Madera, who's been the older brother that I've never had, coming all the way from Venezuela to really help me out. I couldn't have done it without any of them. So thank you.
Thank you so much, and all the best always.
Thank you.